Here we go. What's it?
It's like a race in a way, you know, you don't want to run too fast at the beginning, because if you do that, you're whacked out at the end. So you build up through it, and yeah, I'm not that bothered about things being absolutely in time or absolutely in tune. It's just the best thing is just to get it to feel nice, you know. And I mean, anyone can, you know, any producer, anybody can tell whether a bass guitar and a bass drum aren't absolutely hitting in the same time, you know? You know, that's an easy job. I mean, the difficult job is to get it so that it sounds good as well as that.
My goodness.
It's 10 o'clock, okay?
10 o'clock.
Leader, do we put on?
I don't know. Is it the front?
No, I'll put the leader. I mean, how much of this stuff do we put on?
You'll end up hooking the lorry that delivered the tray.
Can you imagine a very, very successful business trout having 500 Richard Bransons in a little tank?
One of the very few people sit at breakfast with their rod out.
Morning.
Morning.
What?
what remains to be done now today?
Today, well, we got the vocals to do, the anvil, and a couple of little synth bits.
What's the anvil for?
The anvil, just to give it sort of
iron.
Iron type feel, really. Old fashioned.
Men at work, people refueling fire extinguishers all day long, sweating hard, earning the money. Trying to get a dripping water or woodblock sound.
I.e.
Yeah.
Andy, why are you writing on the keys?
Why am I writing on the keys? Well, in fact, I'm a lousy keyboard player and I spent a few hours finding out what notes are what and I mark them where to put my little fingers. So let's find out where to put these grubby little mitts. So we'll whip the track and I'll tune it up.
Okay.
The place has taken on a bizarre quality over the couple of days we've been here. Is it usually like this?
No, it's usually a lot more sleepy. Well, I remember it as being a lot more sleepy than this. We've got all this activity, inflatable castles, 500 tripped, count them, imported, odd comings and goings, the most odd being Richard Branson. Very odd things happening. It's all rather unreal. I think it's coinciding with this once-a-year Virgin Records party, which they not so much throw, but because of its huge, bulky, expensive weight, sort of shove into action. And we just happen to be here doing this at the same time, so...
I'd like somewhere between Dana, Captain Beefheart and Frank Sinatra, I think. Let's drop a fish. Yeah, seems we've had a very fishy weekend.
Well, then, tuners.
All set?
Yeah, all right.
Go.
Here we go. Take it from there.
Towers of London, when they had built you, did you watch over the men who fell? Towers of London, never, never, never is who. Pound, pound, pound.
Yeah, so just that was the last adjustment.
Okay, alright.
Sounding good. We'll take it.
I'm glad he's in such a good mood.
I'll give my dentist a thrill. He occasionally tunes in. Oh, great. Well filled. Nice man. He says, I'll see you on that programme that follows, you know, what's it called? Tomorrow's World.
You say that. Gary and I'm with him all the time. We get all the little comments.
I go to London, go on a tubeway or go across a bridge or something, I never think about, oh, what a nice scene or whatever. I always think about the people who put it up, you know, built the thing in the first place. And I love the old sort of Brunelli type pictures of people putting the railway together, you know, very clean lines, and it'd be like clean stone, just two thin railway lines, and this sort of the ultimate in technology puffing along it. I find all that very exciting, but nobody seems to think about all the people who did it. Imported navvies and nothing short of slightly paid slaves, you know. So I thought I'd write a song with a bit of a dreamy feel to it. It ended up sounding rather 60s more than dreamy, but still the 60s you can only remember in dreams because they're not here anymore. So yeah, it's a kind of a dreamy homage to the people who put it all up song.
Couple of bits to patch up.
My head aches. There's tons of reverb in here, you know. I sound like I'm stood alone in some German submarine pen or something.
Get this submarine finished immediately, or World War II will be over and you have to wait till the next time.